I'm Rabia Tijala-Kopp and I'm presenting my trends for SS18. I'm currently doing the investigation markets and I'm currently working for Jigsaw. So my mood boards are digital. I have this idea of colour booking. I like the idea of primary blocks and mixing and matching colours that are from the primary palette and making the garment stand out in a different way to the normal of neutral colours of black and white. So just adding a few things that I do find inspiring. So if I were to create my own trends and designs, this is how I would see it becoming. So oversized coats with a pop of colour, with skirts that will be completely different to the top's colour, or garments all in one having blocks of colours in different places. So I'll be doing things that would be either one garment being one colour or an entire garment just having different splashes of colours. And with the primary block, colour blocking is a trend that combines contrasting colours from the primary palette to create bold blocks of garments. And when colour blocking is preferred to use complementary colours in garments which would normally be worn with black or basic neutral colours. I also created a mood board for this trend board, which I call Grafika. So it incorporates both tribal tattoo type of patterns, but in a background that is either black or white. So it'll be a very simple but still complex type of style. And this trend emulates rich tribal graphics in classic black and white palette. And Karl Lagerfeld once said, black and white always looks modern, whatever that would be. So it's also something that it can be basic, but it can also be crazy as it possibly can be. It depends on the person's style and what they want to show within their garment and their trend. This trend will be a mix of both tribal graphics on the black and white palette, and the crossover is why I decided to call it Grafika, to show the bond of two trends in one. My range plan for the Grafika will be just four basic palette silhouettes, but something that can come together for Jigsaw. I've decided to sell my collection to Jigsaw, as Jigsaw do tend to follow a quite conservative style, and Jigsaw are looking to break into the younger market. So I've decided to make my trend incorporate asymmetrical patterns and graphics that could appeal to a young audience. And also Jigsaw is known for selling high in the market. They're quite a luxury brand. So in order to penetrate the younger markets, I have decided to have my recommended price points be at a £50 range, so that it is more affordable to the younger generation, because Jigsaw is known for being a 25 to 50 plus type of brand. So I also decided to also sell this to the Jigsaw brand. And Jigsaw are known to do colour blocks, but it also is kind of pushed towards the older customer. So we will still be using the same type of expensive fabrics like cashmere, but in a sense that in a way that would be less watered, it will be more watered down in quality, but still rich in style. So I also want my collection to be for size 6 to 16, which is usually the size range that Jigsaw promote. And the price range will also be less than £100, so it will also appeal to the younger market. And the cost price would be to make these clothes will be quite cheap, as we do use manufacturers that aren't too expensive. So that's that. For my visit to Oxford Street, we visited shops like Topshop, we entered the Topman section, Something that we did really see stand out for Topshop was ruffles, floral print, and corsets. This is something that we'd see on the street as well whilst we were walking around. We just see this trend pop up in many different forms and styles. But we did know that this is something that is fast fashion. So this is what we'd see in places like ASOS, Zara, and New York in different ways, because it all embodies the same styles. We also visited Urban Outfitters for a second, and this is what I prefer in my personal style anyway. You do see these people walking around a lot in London, these cool city creatives, and their go-to places are Urban Outfitters, and Urban Outfitters doesn't really follow the trend of what's fast fashion and what's popular in other stores. Urban Outfitters, you tend to curve towards the vintage styles and more creative with like logos and puffer jackets and just quirky designs in general. We also visited Liberty's London. When you walk into Liberty's, you can just sense the richness as you walk into the store. It's very conservative, very quiet. There's no music playing in the background, which I find really interesting because it's very different to what we see in their neighbouring stores like Topshop and Oxford Street. It just hones in on the styles and what they want to sell. So it doesn't give you too many distractions. The scents are very elegant, and it all just helps in general just promote the calibre of brands that they do sell, which are higher end in comparison to what we find in the high street. We also visited the Anna Sue exhibition. Anna Sue is a fashion designer who started designing and wanted to be a designer since she was 4 years old. She was influenced by her mother, who made her own clothes and tried to show it out in family events. And this is what made her love clothes from a very young age of 4 years old. And then she went on to going on to the Parsons School of Design, which she then became one of the biggest designers in the world. For Pure London, we visited different brands and what they had on offer. They have the collective of exhibition for brands in women's wear, men's wear, and accessories to showcase their own collections and make connections with fashion industry experts who will hopefully take their brand to the next level. They also have the opportunity to scout for agents who will then help promote their own brands and sell their brands to bigger competitors if they want. And we also went to see, during the Pure London exhibition, we got a chance to view a presentation from WGS Cesare Bugoni, and she just explained to us the next year's top trends and colours, which I then took from for my own little trend. The colours that she brought up was rose terracotta, and the styles that she noticed that will pop up next year will be ruffle skirts, which we see now as well. We see a lot of ruffles in shops all over, so it's something that will be a recurring trend. And as a reflection of all of this, all the visits have given me a wider understanding of styles that were previously popular and why they were celebrated at their time, and the current trends and how they are repeated from store to store, showing that they know their customers are currently drawn to them, and finally the future of style and how the past influences the future by recycling trends or changing them to create new trends together. Fashion is ever-growing, is an ever-growing platform of creativity to help showcase not only trends and styles, but also the personalities of its customers. In a world that is growing to become more forward-thinking about cultures and personal life choices, we see this reflected on our wardrobes, and in items in which we would not have been accepted 30 plus years ago are now celebrated and will continue to do so.
Thank you. So I have a couple of questions.
Yeah.
So can you tell me who Jigsaw's global and national competitors are, please?
Whistles and Karen Millen are the main competitors at Jigsaw. They have the same price points, the same customers, and they have the same general sense of style when it comes to a more conservative approach. So that's our competitors.
And what about global?
Global would be... we do like to brand ourselves as a luxury brand, so we would like to do emulate styles from places like Victoria Beckham. Victoria Beckham is a global entrepreneurial brand, and we do have those types of styles, and we do like to hold ourselves in that level.
Good. Okay, and as part of this project, you were asked to do some research into street style. So how did you find your trends working on the high street?
I'd like to have my trend go into more of the Urban Outfitters, Zara type of style. When we were in Oxford Street, I did see a lot of different people. There were people that were following the floral ruffle trends, but there were people that would have like beards and tattoos, and people that would just be wearing different things to the norm. And that's me myself. Like, I don't go for the florals or the ruffles, so I tend to enjoy that look. So what my trend would be, I believe that it would definitely do well, especially the Graphica black and white trend, as it is an autumn winter type of style that could also cross over to summer, spring, summer as well, depending on the actual garment itself. But it can be something that can be woven into both trends and both seasons.